Hi everyone, welcome back. So in this video, we are going to talk about environment setup in Node.js. So locally, we are able to run the application using server.js, using Node.mon. But when we extend this application, we will start using MySQL, Redis, maybe RabbitMQ, some other software we need locally. So why can't we do this using Docker? Using Docker, we just need a MongoDB image, MySQL image, and Redis image, and we can Dockerize and spin up all the containers, and we'll be able to run the application just in a few seconds. Actually, whenever we use a Docker, it is helpful for other developers also to replicate the same environment in their local system. So Docker setup is like this. We are using Docker Compose here. I'm not going into the details. What is Docker Compose and what is Docker? There is a separate playlist which I'm talking about, where I talked about what is Docker, what is Docker Compose, how to write Docker file, how actually Docker works, all these things. So here, what I'm doing here is this is the Docker file for my application, and in this package.json on the start command, I'm running my local environment. Okay, so take a look onto this Docker file. Here I'm fetching the Node.js latest image, creating this working directory in the container, and copying my package.json from here to this directory, doing npm install and copying all the source code to this directory and exposing 3000 port. Now, if you go to the Docker Compose file, there are two containers I'm using, MongoDB and Node. So this Node app and MongoDB. So Node app is actually Node.js app which will be deployed on the container, and it will expose this 3000 port. So this is the port mapping of the container to the host system, and it has a link with the MongoDB system, MongoDB image, and restart always. So whenever I hit, so what will happen if I hit Docker Compose build? It will actually start creating the containers. First, it will build the Node app. So here is my Node.js app. It will use this Docker file to build it. It is just following all these instructions: run, make dir, work dir, copy, run, copy, expose, cmd. All these commands it will run one by one. First, it is fetching the Node.js image, which will take some time, I think. So meanwhile, I will pause the recording. So you can see our image has been built. So I can do Docker Compose up. So now it will create a Mongo app and Node app. So that is done. Here also, so it is initializing the MongoDB and the Node.js app also get started. So here it is running this command, right? Node.mon index.js. But we don't have index.js, it's index.js, so Node.mon is not there. So either we need to install that globally. So I will just move to the Node.js, because it is looking for the Node.js command and I don't have that available. So I will build that command again, because Node.mon not found. This is the Node.js error, and in the MongoDB, let me check what is happening. So MongoDB is able to start. Okay, yeah. So we need to build this again. Either you can do Docker Compose down or Docker Compose build. So it will just, because we updated the Docker file, and we need to build this again. It will be very quick because we already created this image. So it will quickly go to those instructions and all. But we didn't actually, we updated the code, so that updated code need to become into this Docker container. So we need to build it again. It will take a little bit of time. So Well, other things we can check, we are going to run start command, port 3000 node index.js. Okay, we are good at it. So it is copying the files, then it will run all the instructions. So right now we are at this point in the Docker build. So you can see now we are happily able to start the server. Node.js it has already been started and it is talking to the MongoDB. Now for the internal communication, because both are running on the different containers, so if you try to execute the application and try to access the MongoDB, then you will not be able to. The point is, in the Docker Compose, MongoDB, so there is an internal network. Now if the Node.js app need to talk to MongoDB, then you cannot connect it on the local host first of all. So let's see where we are actually connecting to our MongoDB. That should be somewhere in the app.js. Okay. So here we are authenticating it and let's see where we are actually making the connection. Database.connections from the global object. So my point is here, like if you are connecting to the MongoDB here, mongoose.connection, and passing the local host and the user ID password, then what you need to do is you need to pass, you cannot pass the local host because you are right now you are running on a network, you are using the Docker image. So MongoDB is running on some different port. Port is same 27017, but if Node.js wants to talk to the MongoDB, then you need to use host as a MongoDB. That we can talk in the next video. So this is how we can spin up our application onto the Docker container. So now this port 3000 is exposed on the local host and you can access this port.